Hey, welcome to the John Stevens Jr. Made It Through Monday live stream, guys. As you can see, I'm back on the ridge again this week down in beautiful French Lick, Indiana. The wind is blowing harder than it's supposed to be tonight, but I think it's quietly calming down. If you listen close. Hear the choir in the background. We got the birds singing. Hey, every week we get together at 7:30 p.m. And for the next hour, I am going to be playing about 8 songs. 4 of them are going to be mine. Some of them are going to be your request. And we want you to stick around tonight. We're going to be showing some show picks from last week's show. I'm going to let you know where I'm going to be this upcoming week, different shows. We're going to give away some free merchandise. You guys make sure this is the part of the show where everybody's out there just saying hi to each other. So if you're brand new out there, welcome to the John Stevens Jr. Show. If you've been here before, welcome back. We're glad to have you. We're going to start off the show with one of the sheriff, Pam Richardson's favorite songs by that country artist, Jelly Roll. Long-haired son of a sailor. I never get along. I got these ghosts that keep me company. Took the rearview off this old Ford, and I only see what's in front of me. Now the past is out of sight and out of mind. Thought I'd change, but I'm back chasing those white lines. I'm just a long-haired son of a sin, searching for new ways to get gone. I'm a pedal to the highway. If you ever wonder why we write these songs, I'm only one drink away from the devil. I'm only one call away from home. I'm somewhere in the middle. Guess I'm just a little right and wrong. Hey, these back roads got me. These pills pretend to be my friend. I'm done for the last time. I'm lying to myself again. I always say that I'm on my way back here somehow. I should have known by now. I'm just a long-haired son of a sinner, searching for new ways to get gone. I'm a pedal to the highway. If you ever wonder why we write these songs, I'm only one drink away from the devil. I'm only one call away from home. I'm somewhere in the middle. I guess I'm just a little right and wrong. Mistakes I've made, paid for them in cash. Walk a million miles on broken glass. My heart is slowly fading, feeling like it's breaking. I might pop a pill, maybe smoke, maybe drink. Talk to God, ask him what he thinks. First he's gonna hate me, eventually he'll save me. 'Cause I'm just a long-haired son of a sinner, searching for new ways to get gone. I'm a pedal to the highway. If you ever wonder why we write these songs, I'm only one drink away from the devil. I'm only one call away from home. I'm somewhere in the middle. I guess I'm just a little right and wrong. Somewhere in the middle, I guess I'm just a little right and wrong. Oh, jelly roll for you guys out there. Welcome to the John Stevens Jr. Made It Through Monday live stream. Sheriff, thank you for that request out there. I'm going to pull up and see here. There's all my comments. Hey, I just want to look around and see who all's out there. But while I'm doing that, it's that time in the show where I ask a favor of you. Will you guys let me know where you're watching from? Let me know what city. If you're out of state, we'd love to see where you're at. It's check-in and sharing time. Let me know what city you're watching from. If you're out of state, we'd love to hear that. And all you people in Indiana, we put your cities out there. If you would like me to list your city and what you're doing, tell me what you're doing. Tell me where you're watching and make sure and end it with the city that you're doing all those crazy things from. You know, don't just tell me you're swinging on your swing. Tell me what city you're swinging on your swing, and I will put you in the chat next week, all right? So make sure and check in and share. Julie will tell you why. If you share this video at any time tonight, throughout the show, even after it's over during the replay next week, you'll be eligible to win some free merchandise on me. Julie's going to share with more with you on how you can win some free merchandise by sharing this video. So make sure you do that. Say hi to everybody and make sure and hit that like and love button up there. I appreciate that. So Julie's got that going. I'm going to go all the way back here to the top and try to say hi to everybody. You guys, this is the best part of this show. You guys, I think last week there were over 550 comments before I even started looking at them all like that. You guys, this is a great community. If you got are not a part of this, we'd love for you to join us each and every Monday night at 7:30. So I see a lot of people. Pete Arcamo looks like the first one in there. Hi, Dawn. Donna Davis, I got one of your songs tonight. Little Harry Chapin for you. Brene, good to see you this weekend. Mr. Westerfield, Becky down the street, Don Brown and Crawfordsville. Cindy Adamson, I love it. Cindy, all the way up there in Chicago, Illinois. Cindy, thanks for joining us. Julie, of course, is with it. There's Mindy. Happy Monday. Mindy says, happy Monday to everybody. Thanks, Mindy. I appreciate it. Y'all say hi to Mindy out there. There's Orpha up in Michigan. Thank you, Cindy, for checking in Chicago. Larry Davis has joined us. Bob Cruz down in the valley in French Lick. Good to see you, Bob. Becky Cummins. Hey, Becky. There's Becky. She look at there. She goes, I shared. She's trying to win some free merch on me, isn't she? Thanks, Becky. Hey, we saw April and Joe this weekend at my show. Said for them to tell you we said hi. Peg Heck Barton up there in Lafayette. I'm looking through real quick. Becky Boggs has joined us. I'm trying to see if there's Vicky Turner Randall. Hi, Vicky. Good to see you. I missed somebody there. Who was it? Oh, well, I'll catch you later on down the line. I think I said hi to most of you that are in the chat. Make sure to check in. Let me know what city you're watching from. There's Gretchen Lone up in Lafayette. There's my mama watching down on the ridge in French Lick. Beth Donahue Armstrong's joined us. I got to get going, guys. You guys are filling up this chat so much. That's awesome. Vicky Land, I saw out there. Connie Schultz in Lafayette. Andrea, our winner last week. She shared from Buck Creek. She won a free piece of merch off me last week, so congratulations on that. All right, let's get on to our next song. All right, as some of you know, if you follow me on Facebook, we had some storms. There were storms in Indianapolis, tornadoes. They were, I think, 3 touchdown in Orange County, but we didn't have tornadoes, but we had hail. I should have put that picture up there. We had golf ball size hail and hail that was even bigger, not quite baseball size, and I got a picture on my Facebook page. It hammered my windshield, my back windshield, shattered it. So I am still waiting on an adjuster to come out. So I'm stranded on the ridge for at least tomorrow. So hopefully they can get me by Thursday. If not, got to go to Plan B because we got to be in Brownsburg on Thursday for our show. So we'll figure something out. But I told Julie, I decided I wanted to play this song for me because I got to tell myself, hey, it's going to be all right no matter what's going on. And a lot of people sent me comments. I have not had a chance to get back with them. Said, well, you're be thankful there wasn't anything worse. You know, glass can be replaced, right? That's true. I just don't like being inconvenienced. Do you? I don't like being inconvenienced. It happens sometimes, so. But I just thought, I'm going to sing this song to me. I hope if you're going through something out there and you're not sure what the answer is going to be, you just tell yourself, believe in the Lord, it's all going to be all right. Every time I play this song, I can see dancing Larry and Connie getting all over it. I don't know know what I'm gonna tell my friends. I don't know what I'm supposed to be feeling when an old road's ending and a new one begins. I don't know who I'm supposed to turn to find some wisdom when a love burns out. I don't know if there's ever any answers when a man with a plan says it's all going south. But I know the sun's coming up. I got gas in my truck. There's coffee in my cup. I believe in Lady Luck. I won't always be stuck. I'm okay with not much. And some days are gonna suck. I may lose a few pounds now. It's all come unwound. I don't have to drown. My world's upside down. Simple truths are profound. Solitude, it's sacred ground. Hey, I may be down, but I found when you can't see the light. I may not know all the answers, but I know it's gonna be alright. Just keep telling yourself it's gonna be alright. I don't know when I'm gonna get off the ridge, but it's gonna be all right. We'll figure it out. I don't know what I'll have for breakfast. I don't know what the weather's like outside. I don't know if I'll watch an old movie or head down to the dive bar and drink all night. But I know the sun's coming up. I got gas in my truck. There's coffee in my cup. I believe in Lady Luck. I won't always be stuck. I'm okay with not much. Some days are gonna suck. I may lose a few pounds now that it's all come unwound. I don't have to drown, cause my world's upside down. Simple truths are profound. Solitude, it's sacred ground. May be down, but I found when you can't see the light. I may not know all the answers, but I know it's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. It's going to be all right. You know, sometimes when things like this happens, you know, sometimes it turns out better. Not sure how this one's going to turn out better, but stay tuned. Come back next week and I'll tell you if it got better or not. But anyway, if you're going through something rough out there, I hope that song kind of encourages you. Sing it to yourself. It's all going to be all right. Hey, I'm going to check the chat one more time. I'm going to go all the way down to the bottom. Hey, looky there. Kim and Haji shared up in Frankfurt. Thank you. Hello, Jerry Birchfield. Good to see you. It looks like Larry's saying hi to Orpha up in Michigan. Tammy, Tony, good to see you. Thanks for joining us. Thank you, Vicky. She says, great song. Thank you. I'm glad you enjoyed it. Cindy Sharon up in Chicago. Hi there, Diana Kelsey. How are you, sweetie? Good to see you over in Crawfordsville. There's y'all straighten up. Bad Betty is in the house. Now, see, I love this, you guys. There's so many comments to go through. So make sure, if you're brand new out there, make sure and just jump in and say, hi, my name's Larry Davis. That's what Larry Davis did. Larry Davis was, there he is right there. See, Larry Davis was an orphan until he joined us here. And he just said, hi, my name's Larry. No, that's not true. But Larry jumps in there all the time. Larry, good to have you with us. But if you're brand new out there, we'd love for you to jump in the chat. Let us know where you're watching from. Check in, say hi, and make sure and share. And Julie will remind you this. If you share the video to a group, to a bunch of your friends, tag a friend, share it to one of your big groups, and type I shared in the chat. We'll draw your name out. Julie will scrape it out next week and put you in the hopper, and you'll possibly win some free merch on me. Okay, well, let's get on to our next song. We're going to do a little Morgan Wallen Whiskey Glasses. I'm going to tune this up real quick. And it's beautiful here on the ridge right now. All right. But before we do that, let's go see what's happening up in Mulberry. Let's all say hi. My co-producer up in Mulberry is Julie Schultz Corey, and her and Pete are up there in the office. And before I sing a little Whiskey Glasses here, a little Morgan Wallen song, let's see what's going on up in Mulberry. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I tried to get, you guys are already working on your whiskey glasses out there. How in the heck did that happen? You never know what you're going to see up there. You never know what you're going to see up there in Mulberry, that's for sure. Pete and Julie, I love that segment of the show. She goes, are you going to play Whiskey Glass? I think I said, I think I'm going to. So she goes, I got something for you. Pete and Julie, thank you so much for joining us. Julie does a great job. She goes through the chat and scrapes all your shares, and then she puts them on a little whatever they put in the hopper, and Pete turns the hopper for us and pulls out the name, and after a while, we'll get that for you out there. So, Julie and Pete, we appreciate all you do up there in Mulberry. So let's do a little Morgan Wallen for you, a little Whiskey Glasses. I'm spilling water on my mama's porch, don't tell her. Line 'em up, line 'em up, line 'em up, line 'em up. Knock 'em back, knock 'em back, knock 'em back, knock 'em back. Fill 'em up, fill 'em up, fill 'em up, fill 'em up. 'Cause if she ain't ever coming back, pour me another drink. 'Cause I don't wanna feel a thing no more, hell no. I just wanna sip until the pain wears off. Pour me another round. Line them up and knock them down. Two more, let's go. 'Cause I ain't ever heard like this before. Don't want to think about her or wear a ring without her. Don't want to hit the karaoke bar, can't sing without her. Make them drink strong before she's gone. And if I'm ever gonna move on, I'ma need some whiskey glasses. 'Cause I don't want to see the truth. She's probably making out on the couch right now with someone. I'ma need some whiskey glasses if I'm gonna make it through. If I'ma be single, I need a double shot of those heartbreak proof. Let me warm my whiskey glasses. Putting on my whiskey glasses. Pete and Julie had on their whiskey glasses. They were drinking something up there. Last call. I swear this will be my last call. 'Cause I ain't drunk dialing no more at 3 a.m. Mr. Bartender hitting me again. Don't want to think about her or wear a ring without her. I want to hit the karaoke bar, can't sing without her. Make her drink strong before she's gone. And if I'm ever gonna move on, I'ma need some whiskey glasses. 'Cause I don't want to see the truth. She's probably making out on the couch right now with someone new. I'ma need some whiskey glasses if I'ma gonna make it through. If I'ma be single, I'll need a double shot of that heartbreak proof. See the world through whiskey glasses. See the world through whiskey glasses. Light 'em up, light 'em up, light 'em up, light 'em up. Knock 'em back, knock 'em back, knock 'em back, knock 'em back. Fill 'em up, fill 'em up, fill 'em up, fill 'em up. 'Cause if she ain't ever coming back. Light 'em up, light 'em up, light 'em up, light 'em up. Knock 'em back, knock 'em back, knock 'em back, knock 'em back. Fill 'em up, fill 'em up, fill 'em up. If she ain't ever coming back, I'ma need some whiskey glasses. 'Cause I don't wanna see the truth. She's probably making out on the couch right now with someone new. I'ma need some whiskey glasses if I'ma gonna make it through. If I'ma be single, I'll need a double shot of that heartbreak proof. See the world through whiskey glasses. See the world through whiskey glasses. Light 'em up. Light 'em up, light 'em up, knock 'em back, knock 'em back, knock 'em back, knock 'em back. Feel 'em up, feel 'em up, feel 'em up. Since she ain't ever coming back. That girl's gone, let me tell you. She is gone out there. Excuse me. The old sunshine. I'm at a new location, and I have no mark, so obviously I didn't get far enough under the porch. So if I blind, see right here, that's pretty good right there. Right here, you get a little sunshine in the place. So we're going to have to deal with it. We're stuck with our setup right here tonight. But anyway, it's time to recognize our virtual tippers from last week. So we have provided ways for you to say thank you. Let's take a look and see who those virtual tippers from last week's show. From last week's June 19th show, Karen Mills and Brian tipped me $10 using their Zelle. Thank you, Karen. Jay Westfall, all the way out in Texas, tipped me $30. Wow, thank you, Jay, on his PayPal. Pete Arcamo, again, tipped me $10 with his PayPal. Julie Schultz Corey, our co-producer up there in Mulberry, tipped me $10 again on her Venmo. And you know what? There's one I left off. The sheriff tipped me too. Oh, can you type that in for me real quick, Julie? What's this? She's going to fix this for me on the fly. She's going to fix my mistake because Pam Richardson, the sheriff, tipped me and I didn't get that in there. So I was waiting for it to come up. And Julie's going to fix this on the fly for me. This is pretty cool. This is why I have Julie in the co-producer's chair. And she's going, look, there they go. See, we're going to try it again. Sheriff, I did not mean to forget you, but I didn't get your name in there. But thank goodness I remember. Karen Mills, again, with Zelle. Jay Westfall, $30 with his PayPal. Pete Arcamo used $10 using his PayPal. Julie Schultz Corey, $10 with Venmo. And Pam Richardson used $10 on her Venmo, too. I believe it was Venmo. But thank you guys so much for saying thank you with a virtual tip out there. Now, Julie's going to put across it. There's a number of ways. If you would like to say thank you for me bringing these live streams to you, you can tip me too. You can tip me $5. You can tip me $10. I'll even take a $30 tip like Jay Westfall did. That was pretty awesome. But you can use your Zelle, your Apple Pay, your Venmo, your PayPal, your Cash App. There's a site, if you're like me, didn't have any of those things before I started, just go to my website, JohnStevensJrMusic.com. There is a virtual tip jar there. And my friend Faye Coy, who was at my show, she even sent me a message in the chat. Now, a lot of my friends come to my shows, and I have the most generous tippers in my magic tip jar. And Faye goes, you can even get personal checks. So there's a way for that to happen to you. But if you would like to say thank you, here are the options right across the top. If you have a PayPal or a Venmo, you can use it. There's my usernames. If you have a Zelle, Apple Pay, or Cash App, you see the email, see the phone number. Those of you that have those apps, you know how to use those. You can go to the website and leave a virtual tip there. Or like I said, like Faye said, you can write a check and mail it to John Stevens Jr. There's my address if you would like to say thank you. So we've tried to provide a lot of different ways for you guys to do that watch the Monday night show. But we do appreciate your support. Okay, I think we got that covered. Thank you, Julie. You know, all of a sudden, listen, the birds, oh, there's a Bob White. There's a Bob White. My dad used to say, Bob White. Let's see if we hear it again. There's a dove cooing. I don't hear Mr. Bob White. I tried to get him on command. It doesn't happen. But there, he started to. He must have found somebody. He's out there. All right. Well, I'm going to play another one of my songs. I told you that we're going to do four of my own tonight. And I'm going to get me some more water here. Before I go on to this next song, did you guys out there have storms where you're at? I know that sounds like the Greenwood area out there got anything. Your locations, you guys out there, thank you all for the nice comments. I should be paying more attention to my comments out there. Hi, Elizabeth Romaine. Alvin Dickey, good to see you out there, buddy. Did you guys have weather in Crawfordsville? Did you guys have weather on the east side of Indianapolis? Sounds like the south side got hit pretty good. Let me know in the comments if you guys had any storm damage or hail damage like I got. I would be interested in finding that out. Becky Pettit and Brene, and did you guys get any weather? Vicky Land, did you guys get any weather in Lebanon yesterday? Just curious. We got her down here. Cindy Adamson, I saw that. Thank you, Cindy. Just sent a virtual tip on her Zelle. Thank you, Cindy. I appreciate that. Sometimes I see them when I'm doing the live stream, and sometimes I don't. So I won't forget you like I almost forgot the sheriff this week out there, Cindy, next week. Thank you for that. I do appreciate that. But I don't know why I taped this guy up. I'm not singing this guy yet. I'm singing my favorite thing about God is I'm his favorite thing. I had this thought for a song a long time ago. And make sure my tuning's back where it belongs after that cable. And I just started singing. My favorite thing about God is I'm his favorite thing. I just thought, oh, that's kind of cool. I didn't know where to go with it. And I started doing, I just typed in Google, you know. And there's all kinds of articles about God and about how he is big enough to love us like everybody. He'd have died on the cross. Jesus would have died on the cross for us if it was just us, just one of us. So I guess that song made sense to me. So I found a lot of articles that kind of validated my thoughts and wrote a little song. I play it for you tonight. It's called My Favorite Thing About God. Well, Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. First song I learned to sing in school. Since then God taught me about amazing grace, how to pray and believe and walk by faith. He asked him his old song to set us free, to die for the world, but he'd have done it for only me. Oh, my favorite thing about God is I'm his favorite thing. He rejoices and shouts the way I'm turning out, in his time on his watch by his name. I'm in the palm of his hand every day, fearfully and wonderfully made, created for his good pleasure. So I'll worship and sing. My favorite thing about God is I'm his favorite thing. I don't know about you, but I got a few pages torn like an old Bible. I'm weathered and worn. My whole life's been a journey. God shed his mercy on me. Some days I wonder what tomorrow holds, but I'm glad I don't know all he planned long ago. So I'll just trust in his word and what he whispers to me. He might even have bigger plans than I could believe. Oh, my favorite thing about God is I'm his favorite thing. He rejoices and shouts the way I'm turning out, on his watch and his time by his name. I'm in the palm of his hand every day, fearfully and wonderfully made, created for his good pleasure. So I'll worship and sing. You know my favorite thing about God is I'm his favorite thing. Well, you might think I'm conceited, another self-righteous fool, but I'll let you in on a secret, you're God's favorite too. Oh, my favorite thing about God is I'm his favorite thing. He rejoices and shouts the way I'm turning out, on his watch and his time by his name. I'm in the palm of his hand every day, fearfully and wonderfully made, created for his good pleasure. So I worship and sing. Favorite thing about God is I'm his favorite thing. Make sure you tell yourself that tomorrow. My favorite thing about God is I'm his favorite thing. I'm sure glad he's God and can love us all that way. That's bigger than I can, that's for sure. Glad you guys enjoyed that song. Glad you guys enjoyed that song. Make sure, if you're just joining us again, my name is John Stevens Jr. Welcome to the John Stevens Jr. Made It Through Monday live stream. That is the second song that I've played of my own tonight. And every week we get together at 7:30 p.m. Eastern time. We're glad to have you with us. We sing for about an hour. We give away some merchandise. We're going to show some, that's hard for me to say, show some show picks. Show, how can I say that different? I'll work on that next week. We're going to share some show picks. That's harder for me to say. Those are ours. Anyway, we're going to do that, give away some merch. Make sure, if you haven't already, thank you, Charletta. I appreciate that. Glad to have you with us. It's Carletta. I called you Charletta. Carletta, thank you very much. I appreciate that. Thank you for joining us. Glad to have you with us. But make sure, if you guys are out there watching, make sure you have checked in. Make sure you've said hi to everybody. Make sure you've hit that like button up there. Looks like we got about 49 hearts and likes and loves up there. So make sure you hit that love button out there. Share it with your friends. Share it in your groups. And make sure after you share it, you type I shared in the chat so you can win some free merch on me. All right, Julie, I'm going to stick to my notes. It says it's time for last week's check-ins. Now, if you guys check in this week, you people from Indiana, we appreciate you. You check in, make sure and tell me what city you're watching from. You can tell me anything else you're doing and I'll put it in there. But if you want me to put your check-in in there, make sure and put the city along with it. But last week we had people check in from out of state. Julie, they're running. My good buddy David Holman, Aunt Teresa's brother, checked in from Rock Springs, Wyoming. Andrea checked in. I think she's down at her daughter's down in Northport, Florida. That is awesome. She's out of town and checking in. Thank you, Andrea. Orpha Wyan, our favorite South Haven, Michigan girl, checks in every week. Thank you, Orpha. The Salt Gal from Saltville, Virginia, joined us. Tracy Livingston was in New Buffalo, Michigan, on the road on a trip, vacation, and checked in with us. That's awesome. David and Nancy Hunt checked in from Florida. David was my co-writer on Permanent Vacation. Ruthie Wessel says hello from Florida. Family Ron Miller checked in from Louisville, Kentucky. Thanks for joining us, Ron. I appreciate that. There's our friend Sydney Adamson checking in from Chicago, Illinois last week. Robert Mellis says howdy and is watching from the loft and an upper deck view of the Eastern Franklin Mountains in El Paso. Now, I got to tell you, Robert, that is one heck of that's a fine check-in. And Julie's going to let those scroll through one more time. But I had to check that out because I said, where the heck is that? He put El Paso. And I'm thinking, where is that? And I guess it's on the northern part of El Paso, maybe. I don't know. That's what Mr. Google told me. But thank you for that check-in. So all you guys from out of state, if you're watching tonight, we would love for you to let us know where you're watching. And even if you're out of the country, I know that we're starting to get a lot of foreign viewers out there, international viewers. If you're watching from out of the country, say hi, pop your head up and let us know where you're watching from. And also, I'm going to wave and say hi to all you that are watching on YouTube out there. I know that we are broadcasting to YouTube. So if you're on YouTube out there, make sure and say hi. And thank you for checking in. There's a new person out there. No, that's just Debbie McIntyre. Good to see you. Glad to have you with us. Lynn is from Crawford. So, all right, Julie, let's look at our in-state check-ins from last week. We had people check in from Thorntown, Rochdale, home in Greenwood, Redneck Acres in Lebanon. That's Mr. Nelson, I believe. Watching from the Lyman Ranch, East Lafayette on YouTube. I think it was Eli and Renetta, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. Watching from Crawfordsville, Indy. There's our friend Mary and Charlie Newland. Watching from Raccoon Lake with friends from Wyoming. I met your friends from Wyoming Friday night. My show, I got pictures we're going to share here in just a bit. Out back in Chapel Hill, Hillsboro, Indiana. Rehab Center, that's Elaine. Elaine, bless your heart, still hanging on there in Anderson. Fort Brands, that's a new one for us. Thank you for checking in. Out back of the house in New Ross, Lebanon. In the kitchen in Frankfort. Outside again, Chapel Hill. Suburban Claremont. I love these checkouts out there. Watching from the kitchen in Lafayette. You guys are doing a good job putting those cities on there. Somebody else checked in from Anderson. That's great. Watching from the Harrison, watching from Harrison Steel in Attica. That's Cindy Clemenger. Thank you, Cindy. Shared from Crawfordsville, Danville, big city near East Side, Indy. Thank you, guys. Seville again. And listening from Lafayette. I do appreciate when you guys take time to let me know what city you're watching from. And all you guys out there that you write some crazy check-ins, I love it. Make sure and write that crazy check-in and make sure include your city where you're watching from. Julie's gonna let them scroll one more time through there. I'm gonna check my tuning before we get on to the next song. Perfect. Unbelievable. All right, let's see where I'm at on my list here. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's that time. Julie, it's vote off time. All right. You guys are going to get to pick between two of my songs. Both these songs I wrote with my buddy River James. River's is a great young songwriter, great young singer. I believe he's living in Noblesville now. And we wrote a handful of songs together. So two of the songs we're going to play tonight, you guys get to choose. We're going to either play Down Here at the Bottom or we're going to play Gunsmoke. Now, Gunsmoke is a song that some of you have heard before. I played both of them on the show. I played Gunsmoke a time, too. I told him the first time he brought this song idea to me, we're liable to get a visit from the FBI with this song. But it's just a song. It's just a song out there. So we're not trying to cause no revolutions or anything. But I like the sentiment out there. So you guys let me know in the chat. Type in the chat whether you want me to play Down Here at the Bottom or Gunsmoke. All right. Here's the deal. Whatever song doesn't win tonight will be the runner-up, and it will be played on next week's show. So last week's runner-up is getting ready to be played here before the show's over tonight, too. So let me know. You want to hear At the Bottom or Gunsmoke? So I'm going to get them both up here, get them ready. Julian, let's give it another 60 seconds. When we get to almost 38 minutes in the show, we'll pick one, okay? Julie does a great job. She scrapes all the shares for me. I make her do all this hard stuff. And now she's becoming part of the show. She's got wearing whiskey glasses. Last week, she was smooching, carousing with Pete. This week, she's getting all liquored up using whiskey glasses. I don't know what they're going to be up to next. I'm going to have to watch out. So we got about 30 seconds to go. Let me know, do you want to hear At the Bottom or Gunsmoke? Whatever the winner is in the chat is what we're going to play. I see Peg says Gunsmoke. Dawn says Down at the Bottom. I don't know. I don't know what it's going to be. So if you got a preference, you better let us know. Julie, 10 more seconds and let's pick one. What do you say? Drum roll, please. Thank you for sharing twice. Gunsmoke. I kind of figured it might be. You guys are more familiar with that one. Now, don't get upset. It's just a song. And it's getting windy down here, so I got to tape my lyrics down. I know most of these. I do this song. When I'm in Jasper, I get this song requested a lot. And I do it, but I thought, well, I haven't done it for a while. I haven't done it on a live stream. So I'm going to make sure and get her hunkered down. Just like when Angela Buckman says, you better get hunkered down. There's a big storm coming in. Now what I do to myself. There it is. All right. I'll need you later. Don't go anywhere. All right. Put you back. Gunsmoke. It says, drop D on the capo on the floor first. So let's get it. So let's throw this capo on here. You know, there's a lot of crazy things going on in the world, and, you know, I'm not going to get political on you. This song kind of is political, but it don't mention any side. It just, you know, we need the law to be followed. We need to make sure our Constitution is followed, our rights are protected. That's what this song's about. River James, thank you for bringing this song idea to me. Really proud to write it with you. Went on that capo. Uh-oh. Listen, hear that? Beep. Mulch is arriving. Hey, Mom, if you're watching, mulch truck's here. We might have the mulch guy come up on the live stream. You never know what you'll see at the ridge. But he's beeping back. All right. Okay, I think we're there. Little Gunsmoke. Thank you. These embers burning like coals in a hot stove. Today's dawning, waking up's been a long road. Now it's time to make our stand. Say it loud, say it proud to the people who tell their lies about hate and the COVID flu. It ain't no accident, it's all planned. Now it's a good day to have a reckoning. Like a Sunday morning sinner crawling up from sinner confessing all their sins. We want justice served, we want our rights preserved the way our founding fathers wrote. We want to follow the law, if y'all can't do your jobs, we'll bring the rope and the gun smoke. Line them up single file at the courthouse. Politicians talk on both sides of their mouth. Let's get them on record and hear their truth. While we're at it, corporations and the fake news can get in line right behind them like they always do. They're gonna talk their talk, but let's see some proof. Man, it's a good day to have a reckoning. Like a Sunday morning sinner crawling up front center confessing all their sins. We want justice served, we want our rights preserved the way our founding fathers wrote. We want to follow the law, if y'all can't do your jobs, we'll bring the rope and the gun smoke. Justice, power to truth, power to freedom and our rights to choose. Power to the people, we've had enough. Power to God up in heaven above. Now it's a good day to have a reckoning. Like a Sunday morning sinner crawling up front center confessing all their sins. We want justice served, we want our rights preserved the way our founding fathers wrote. We want to follow the law, but if y'all can't do your jobs, we'll bring the rope and the gun smoke. Timbers burning like coals in a hot stove. The day's dawning, waking up's been a long road. I know my buddy, fraternity brother, Mr. Jeff Alford, loves that song out there. I don't know if Alfie's out there, but oh, looky there. Looky there. Now, Tracy, I tell you what, we're going to get that script. We'll sing happy birthday to you next week, all right, girly? We appreciate that. What we do on the birthdays out there, we'll make sure and get that scrape for you, sweetie. Everybody wish Tracy this week a happy birthday. Tracy, am I going to see you here in a couple weeks? Like a week from Sunday, maybe? Or is it this Sunday? Is it this Sunday? I think it's a week from Sunday. Yeah, it is a week from Sunday, isn't it? I don't know. Maybe it's this Sunday. We got a private party I think we're going to be doing. Everybody say hi and happy birthday to Tracy out there, all right? With that being said, it's time to get on to a song for Donna Davis out there. Donna, if you guys have a special song you want out there, and let me get back to the birthdays while I'm saying it. What we do is anybody that had a birthday since last Monday's shows to this Monday, we put them on the list. It'll get them blasted up there. So Tracy, next week we will put you on that list and get your happy birthday greeting in there. But everybody out there can wish Tracy a happy birthday tonight. And then next week you can do it again. So Tracy, we'll sing happy birthday to you again. 27, 28, is that what you're going to be? I think so. See, like, you're going to double dip. This is awesome because next week we're going to put your name up there in the birthday banner. and everybody's going to say happy birthday, and we're going to sing it to you next week. We didn't have anybody this week tell me last week that their birthday was coming up. So anyway, if your birthday is between now and next week, Monday's show, we'll put you on that list out there. All right, I think I got that cleared up. All right. And also, if you have a special song that you would like to hear, if you have a request, send me those requests out there, because we know every week we're going to play four of my songs. You request my songs too, that's part of it. But if you have something special, I'm not going to sing any Taylor Swift, no Shania Twain, not going to happen. But if you got something out there, probably no Freebird. We would love to work your request in the show. So make sure and put it in the chat if you have a special song you'd like to hear. Okay, we're back home. It says Cats in the Cradle. Donna has been asking for this song. I still got Becky Knowles Cummins' request of you could read my mind in there. Just had a few too many slow songs tonight, Becky, but your song's still on there. But if you guys do have a request you want me to play, put it in the chat or send me a message. I would love to hear from you, and I would love to play your song during the John Stevens Made It Through Monday live stream out there. See, look at there. Vicky Land did it. Look at there. Look what she did. Tennessee Whiskey. That just might be on show. That just might be on show next week. Who knows? It's on the list, that's for sure. Okay. For Donna Davis. Donna, thank you for requesting this song. Whenever I see Donna at a show, I always... It's just one of those unspoken requests. I have a lot of that with my friends out there that come to my show on a regular basis. I know what they want to hear. So, Donna, here's one for you on the John Stevens Jr. Made It Through Monday live streams home show. Well, a child arrived just the other day. Came to the world in the usual way. But there were planes to catch, bills to pay. Learned to walk while I was away. And he was talking, boy, I knew it. And as he grew, he said, I'm gonna be like you, Dad. You know I'm gonna be like you. Yeah, the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon. There's a little boy blue and a man in the moon. When you're coming home, son, I don't know when. We'll get together then. We're gonna have a good time then. Son turned 10 just the other day. I said, thanks for the ball, Dad. Come on, let's play. Can you teach me to throw? I said, not today. I got 2 months to do. He said, that's okay. He walked away and he smiled, never dipped and said, I'm gonna be like you. You know I'm gonna be like you. Yeah, the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon. There's a little boy blue and a man in the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when. We'll get together then, son. We're gonna have a good time then. He came from college just the other day. So much like a man, I just had to say, son, I'm proud of you. Can you sit for a while? He shook his head. Said with a smile, what I'm feeling like, Dad, is just to borrow the car keys. See you later, can I have them, please? And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon. There's a little boy blue and a man in the moon. When you're coming home, son, I don't know when, but I promise, Dad, we'll get together then. We're gonna have some good times then. Since retired, my son's moved away. I called him up just the other day. I said, I'd like to see you if you don't mind. It's love to Dad if I could find some time. You see, my new job's a hassle and the kids got the flu. It's been sure nice talking to you. It's been sure nice talking to you. And as he hung up the phone, it occurred to me, grown up just like me. My boy, was just like me. And the cats in the cradle and the silver spoon, little boy blue and a man in the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when we'll get together then, son. Gonna have a good time then. Wow, wow. Is that song so true out there? We always think we're going to have forever to get things done and get together with friends and get together with your kids, and it just don't always happen, does it? Wow, that song is heavy. I tell you, I play that song doing a single act sometimes, especially through the week. Sometimes some of them old honky-tonk bars, those five-star dive bars, start off a little bit slow, and you'll have a bunch of bruisers at the bar. You know, maybe 6 or 8, 10 guys sitting there, and they're all talking about football, and they could care less about me up there singing till they have a few of them beers. But I tell you, one song that gets their attention, it's that one right there. They kind of stop what they're doing, and everybody thinks about that. So, hey, let's just make a pact. Pinky swear between now and next week that we're going to try to get out there and say hi to more of our friends. Not stick to ourselves, give our kids a call. I'm excited because my daughter is coming into Nashville Thursday, I believe, maybe Wednesday night, and I'm going to get to see her. So I'm excited about that. She's coming back home from Los Angeles. So I'm going to put that song into practice of making more time for my family and kids. So anyway, let's get on to the next part of the show. It's time for last week's show picks. I'm going to get a swig. There's something about Southern India. I don't know what it is. Just takes my voice away. But here we are. So I want to go to my brand here. We started the week off last week, Thursday night, down at JR's Bar. And we had a big time down there. And, you know, some nights when I'm out at shows, you know, it's like, I'm getting picked, and some nights I just don't get a lot. It's kind of like, you know, I get busy talking, and next thing you know, break's over, and I didn't get any picks. So I got a handful of picks from the show down in Jasper. Here's two of my faves. Oh, there's Tammy, and there's Marilyn. So they are two of my faves down there that show up at JR's Bar down in Jasper. Well, I did a party for Woody and Marilyn last weekend. So they got John Stevens last Saturday, and then this Thursday they turn around and show up again. So Marilyn and Tammy, we appreciate you. We appreciate your friendship, and I know they're good friends with Mom, and check and say hi to her all the time. So we're glad to have you with us. Glad to have you part of our circle. And, you know, you've heard me sing that song about Woody. You know, Woody was the one last week with the T-shirts. Now, the way I see this picture, I don't know, maybe it's just me. Woody is sitting there minding his own daggone business. I've been in that position. I've been in that position, minding my own business, and some pretty girl comes up and starts, you know, it's part of Woody's harem out there. Christine is just, she's just, I said, pretend like you like Woody, and I think she does. So, Christine and Woody, thank you guys for coming out. Good, always good to see you. There's my girl, Georgie and Brenda out there. Georgie, we changed the words to the old Conway Twitty song, I'm Lying Here with Linda, and we changed it to I'm Lying Here with Georgie. On my mind, she just loves it. We love you, Georgie. And Brenda, thanks for coming out. And my buddy Mike Beck, there he is sitting with Brandy. He likes to make it like a nightclub show, you know. So it's usually dark. I got to work on my picture taking in the dark there. But there's Mike and Brandy. And there's Mr. Bump Bump himself on the right, Mr. Mark Schmidt out there. Thanks for joining us, buddy. Mark helped me carry all my gear out and at the end of the show and bought me a captain and said, you got to watch him. He'll buy you a captain in 7 out there. I appreciate that. And there they are again, two Brendas with Georgie hanging out there at JR's Bar. All right, that's all I grabbed on Thursday night. But then Friday night, it was just the opposite. It was a blowout. I was at the press week in Avon. If you guys have not been there, I'll be back, I think in August, maybe next month. I don't know. I'll have to check my schedule and find out. But I will be back at the press book. But we had a great time. It's a fun room, great food, and great atmosphere for live music. And the only reason I'm there, I bring up my first picture, is Janet and Bill Bell. Janet and Bill had their wedding reception at, they got married at the Presswick, and I met Jenny, the bar manager, at their wedding reception. She goes, would you be interested in coming to play at the bar? I said, sure. So I've been there ever since. But I would not have had that happen without Janet and Bill. Janet, Bill, thank you for your friendship. What an honor to be asked to play at somebody's wedding, play at somebody's funeral. Those are great things that I really appreciate it. But Janet, Bill, I wouldn't be at the Presswick without you guys. So I appreciate your friendship. Great to see you there on Friday night. Now, there's Abby, and there's the birthday boy, David. Now, I said, is this your date or your husband? And she goes, yeah, he's my date. I think she was fibbing. But it was David's birthday. So David said he was going to do something special, but he said it was like a dirty joke. And I said, we'll save it for next time. But happy birthday to David out there. And then there's Mary and Charlie Newland. They checked in from Raccoon Lake and said they had friends from Wyoming. And Mary, I didn't check my messages. She's from Germany. That's Tony. Tony and Charlie were friends in the army. Hadn't seen each other forever. And they got together and they were visiting. Michela, is that her name? I can't remember. But she got up, was doing a little solo dancing, drinking, taking pictures. She was having a good time. Speaking of drinking, having a good time, there's my friend Kay. Her and her date were sitting on the front row. John, that was easy to remember. And I was at the bar and the bar manager goes, hey, John, somebody wants to buy you a drink. And I said, okay. And it was Kay. And I said, well, Kay, since you bought me a drink, I said, can we take a picture? She said, sure. So, Kay, thank you for the bantering back and forth. Whenever you sit on the front row to John Stevens Jr. Show, you know that you're going to get a lot of conversations back and forth. And let's see, there was the road crew. There's Gail. Gail's always out there reserving the table. Scott, there's Michelle and Christopher back there. Kathleen joined us. Pete and Julie and Dance and Larry. Thank you, guys. It was a full house on Friday night. I tell you, we had a great time. And look at that. Frida and Janet also made the show. Thank you, ladies, for coming out. I'm in your neck of the woods, so it's good to see you there. Now, Janet told me, she goes, hey, I want to get a picture with this one guy. And I said, where is he? Bring him up. So here it is. I think our show, because of Woody Fisher, our show is starting to go downhill a little bit, maybe go to that PG range, but here it is. She goes, I want my picture. I won't say what it is. You can read his shirt, but Janet goes, I want a picture with this guy. So anyway, might be a sentiment of a lot of people out there, but Janet and Frida, thank you for making the show. I appreciate that. And then there's our girl, our friend Mindy, and her dad, David. Glad to have you guys with us. And there is Valerie and Michael. They're expanding the circle out there. We appreciate you guys for doing that so much, for telling your friends and coming to John Stevens Show. As you can tell, the place was full on Friday night. Let's see here. There's Christine and Chris. And let me think. Patria, I'm not sure how you say it. Patria, Danielle, Mike, and Dennis. I got them all. Thank you guys for making the show there at the Presswick. And they got some more here. Who we got here? Oh, yeah, there's our friends Jim and Ann that come from Brownsburg to our shows at the local. And they brought some friends. And somehow we missed Joe, Becky. Joe's missing out there. But we got Gene, the dancing machine right there, Debbie. And we have Ann and Jim. Then on the backside there is Bill and Loretta and Becky. Thank you guys for joining us on Friday night. Glad to have you with us. And here was a couple friends that just were really enjoying the show. Very attentive and watching online. Jeff and Cheryl, thanks for being there. So that's what we had going on Friday night. Now, Saturday night, we headed to Rochdale to the 9 East Bar and Grill. And one of our friends who is in the chat most weeks here in the John Stevens Jr. Made It Through Monday live stream is Kara McGill. And I said, oh, Kara, we have got to get a picture. So if Kara's out there, Kara, thank you for watching again tonight. And I'll be going through the comments after a while, but we had to get a picture. So Kara, thanks for coming out Saturday night to the 9 East Bar and Grill in Rochdale. And there were a lot of Johns there that night. This is John and Bonnie. Thank you guys for coming out. Good to see you. And if you needed help, like I said, you just asked for John. The owners, John and Courtney, another John in the house had a picture. So we'll be coming back in August. I believe August 19th is when I'm coming back to 9 East. And they said we'll be scheduling some more shows with them later on this fall. So stay tuned for that. But John and Courtney, good to finally meet you guys, owners of the 9 East Bar and Grill. And guess what? Another daggone John, only he's with a Mary. John and Mary were in the house. Thank you guys for joining us. Appreciate that. And there is Christina, and what did I put her name down as? Was it Dorsha? I think it was Dorsha. And Carol, thank you all for coming. Christina, she bought me a cocktail too. Thank you, Christina. I appreciate that. Now, this next picture, I want you all to know, Brené got left out, so I've got three. I got three pictures of Brené because she got left out of last week's because the picture they got was kind of blurry. So, but looky here. There is Christina and myself. There's Gary and Susan and Brené. They made it out to the show. So thank you for coming out. Now here's, I want you all to check this out. This is Gary's van here. Shit, look at that hippie shippy van there, little Chevy van. And we're all out in the street checking that out after the show. Pretty awesome wheels. Awesome ride right there. But Gary and Susan, thanks for coming. Another picture of Brené. And then, of course, me and Brené had to get a little selfie together. So, Brené, I hope that makes up. Hope that makes up for the boy picture. And there's Mr. Miller, Craig. Craig, that's your wife. I can never remember your wife's name. Tell her not to get mad at me. I will get it next time. I am really good with names, but for some reason I cannot remember your wife's name. But I'll do better next time. But Craig was in there. First thing he requested was Sugar Creek. And I appreciate you showing up, brother. And Becky Cummings, your daughter April was there with her husband, Joe. So good to see April and Joe in the house. Glad to have you. So that was some pics from last week's. Hey, this week, Thursday night, I'm going to be playing at the local in Brownsburg. One of my favorite rooms. If you guys are looking to get out for an early show, early dinner. I start at 7 o'clock. Come out early for dinner, about 6 o'clock. If you want to catch my show in the bar room, I recommend that you get reservations because we have a great following there, and it fills up pretty quick. So if you want to come catch the show, make sure you get reservations. But it kind of trickles out maybe before the whole night is over with, so you can probably get a seat for the night's over with. But love to see you at the local in Brownsburg Thursday night. Friday night, one of my favorite places to play. Be back at the Kickstand Bar and Grill in Danville. Shelby and Scotty going to be there. Mr. Disbro will be in the house. I know running karaoke after my show. But come see me Friday night, all right, at Danville. That show starts at 7:30. Stick around after my show's over, and you can come sing some karaoke. All right, that'd be great. Saturday night, I have a private party up in Lafayette, all right? A little Christmas in July party. So looking forward to that. And like I said, I believe Sunday I have a private event that I'm going to be doing, also a private party. So it's going to be a busy 4 days for me, but two shows that y'all can come to. And Tracy, I'll see you Sunday, I believe, at that private party. So, and if you guys would like to book a private event with me, contact me. My number's here. You can message me in the chat, or you can send me a private message. I would love to come to your house. And whatever, if you have a company event or you got a holiday event coming up here this year, I still have some select dates open on the weekends. I'd love to come entertain you, even do a house party. Sometimes we even do events with like 25-30 people just sitting around the house, and we can do shows like that. So if you'd like me to come entertain you, and heck, we might even do a live stream from your house one night. That'd be fun. So get in touch with me. All right. That's that. After this song, this is last week's runner-up, and I better take the words up to this one. I love this song. James Dean Hicks is one of my favorite country songwriters. I think he wrote this song when he was like 19 years old. He wrote Conway Twitty cut it first. Blake Shelton did a version of it. But James Dean Hicks is just, he wrote, remember the Kenny Chesney song, Grandpa Told Me So? He wrote that one. Bunch of other big hits, but both those number one songs. Goodbye Time. Blake Shelton covered this one later. this was last week's runner-up. So, like I said, next week we will play the runner-up of At the Bottom for you next week. So this week we're going to sing Goodbye Time, Conway Twitty, Blake Shelton song. And then we're tossing it to Julie to see if you can win some free merchandise on me. Well, it's your life. You say you need a change. Don't all the dreams we've seen come true mean anything? You say it's different now, and you keep staring at the door. How can you walk away? Don't it matter anymore? If being free is worth what you leave behind, and if it's too late for love to change your mind, then it's goodbye time. Our love would come to this. We could have saved our hearts the hurt of wasted years. But it's been fun. What else can I say? If the feeling's gone, words won't stop you anyway. If being free is with what you leave behind, and if it's too late for love to change your mind, goodbye time. Wows. Wow. Write a song like that when you're 19 years old. Number one country song out there. Awesome. The great James Dean Hicks. Hey, guys, it's that time of the show. It's that time of the show, that it's drawing time. So let's pass it on to Julie. Julie, take it away. Let's get us a winner tonight. There we go.
Hope everybody's having a great Monday evening. We just got some pouring rain showers a few seconds ago. Thought maybe for a minute we might lose you, but we hung in there. All right, so let's give away some merch on John. How about that? So I'm going to run across the screen while I'm telling our newbies how they can get a chance to win a mug, our sharers from last week. So what you need to do if you would like to have a chance to win our Made It Through Monday mug on John, all you have to do is share the video. You can share it now. You can share it after we watch it. Share it to your group pages. Share it with your friends. Just make sure that you type "I shared" in the chat so we can go back through and write down your name and put your name in the hopper. And Pete will spin the names and he draws them out. And I will contact you via instant message. So if you're tonight's winner, Make sure you look at your messages because I'll need to know what color you would like and where you would like us to send it to. All right, Pete, give it a whirl. All right, make sure you type I shared. Tonight's winner is, Sherry Chastain. You are tonight's winner. So I will be contacting you and we'll get a mug out to you. Everybody say congrats to Sherry Chastain. She won the Made It Through Monday mug tonight. All right, John, back to you.
Hey, thanks, Julie. I appreciate that. Pete and Julie do a great job up there. And Pete and Julie are such great supporters. If you notice, when you go through my virtual tips, every week there's this Pete Arcamone and Julie Schultz Corey. They are great friends and great encouragers and believers of me. And they donate their time to help me. And Pete, he's always texting me too. He goes, hey, we're here. When you're ready to bring your stuff in, we'll help you carry it in. So Pete and Julie, I appreciate you guys, all you do for me. I appreciate it a whole bunch. I'm here on the ridge. Like I told you, I'm kind of stranded for a day or two waiting on the adjuster to show up and see if I can at least get my window repaired so I can get up and down the highway again. Don't have anywhere to be but Thursday in Brownsburg, Friday in Danville, Saturday up in Lafayette, and then I forget, somewhere around Greencastle, I have a private party on Sunday too. So four shows, and then we got to turn around and sing on Monday. That'll be like five in a row, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. I might have to get Julie singing a song or something. Maybe she can do that for me. Anyway, guys, thank you for joining us. We're going to do one more song since I'm on the ridge. You know, I was born in Jasper, about 45 minutes from here. My mom and dad lived in French Lick, not here. They've been here 25 years or so. My dad left us about 4 years ago now. I can't believe it's been that long. Mom's still here, so I just felt like my last song tonight I wanted to sing back home, even though this is not where I was raised. Coming to the ridge feels like coming back home to me, so for those of you that might be missing your home out there, this one's for you. It's off my very first album. Seems like I've been on the road since I learned how to drive. Rambling fever and wanderlust, just a way of life. From Fresno, California, to the Mason-Dixon line, my heart still goes when I'm out on the road. Playing my songs and my guitar in those Nashville neon lights. I've landed in Las Vegas where the stars stay out all night. I've been down to Corpus Christi where those gentle golf waves roll, but my heart still goes now and then back home. Back home, when Dad bought me my first pickup truck. Back home, where me and Cassie Rogers first made love. A place where I met Jesus when I was just 13 years old. My heart still goes when I'm out on the road. Back home. I've walked the straight and narrow road, seen both sides of the fence. I've hit some highs and sure felt some lows. Ain't much in life I've missed. So when it's time to say goodbye to the dream that won't let go, first place I know I'm gonna go is back home, where Mom cooks Christmas dinner every year. Back home, where me and Larry Weaver drank our first beers. A place my childhood memories time and seems so clear, my heart still goes. I'm out on the road, back home, where we went to church every Sunday, come rain or shine. Back home, where we were always taught to be humble, be kind. I've been a million places, but there's nowhere else I'll find a rest for my soul like I do when I go back home. I need to go back home. I need to go back home. Guys, I hope that home for you is every Monday night at 7:30 p.m. Eastern time right here at the John Stevens Jr. Made It Through Monday live stream show. We appreciate you joining us. We appreciate you checking in, smashing the like and love button. We appreciate you sharing, and we appreciate all your encouragement and words. Julie and Pete, thanks a lot. It's that time of the show, guys. We're going to say goodnight. I will stick around just for a little bit and look at some of the comments and say hi to you guys as you leave. And we appreciate you all sticking around. But we're going to sing this one, and I'll tell you all goodnight. Turn out the lights. Party's over. They say that all good things must end. Turn out the lights. The party's over. We'll see you down the road next Monday night, 7:30 p.m. Eastern time, and we'll do it all again. We will probably be back at the Davis Dale Kitchen next Monday night. Who knows, though? Who knows? But, guys, thank you so much for hanging with me. And, Bob, good to see you out there. Tracy, good night. Thank you, Jenny Lee Smith. Thank you, Don Brown, Vicki Turner. Andrew, thanks for joining us, guys. We'll see you all down the road. Mike Westerfield, Becky Pettit, thank you. Lena, Robert, out in Texas, thank you. There's my mama. Thank you, Cindy. Thank you, Bob Cruz. I tell you what, we got a lot of faithful regulars in here. Thank you, guys. See you Thursday night in Brownsburg, and see you Friday night in Danville. Good night, everybody. Thanks, Julie and Pete. See y'all next week.